This is the beautiful and picturesque area of Scheveningen, the Netherlands. During the summer months, hundreds of thousands of people, both young and old, come here to enjoy the sun, sand, and surf of this North Sea tourist area. Both Europeans and American service members on their free time travel from the neighboring countries of Belgium and Germany, and some even from further away, to enjoy the relaxing atmosphere of this resort town and the friendliness of the Dutch people. During the month of July, a special group of people come to this area and the neighboring town of Den Haag. And for 3 days, what they come for is jazz.
From the Congress Bowl at Den Haag, the Netherlands, the American Forces Network Europe presents musical highlights of the 1983 North Sea Jazz Festival, featuring the music of Woody Herman, Chick Corea, the James Cotton Band with Albert Collins, Nina Simone, VSOP2, the Icebreakers with special guest Sugar Blue, the Jimmy Smith Trio, and the Oscar Peterson Trio. And now, it's showtime.
With concerts going on in any one of 9 different halls at any given time, the North Sea Jazz Festival is a music lover's paradise. We begin with the big band sound of Woody Herman and his young thundering herd.
Sergeant Ken Washington, we're backstage at the North Sea Jazz Festival with Woody Herman, who just finished his second set of the evening, and a beautiful set at that. Woody, I noticed in your band, you have a lot of young talent. Where do you find it all?
Well, most of these guys have attended one great music department or another at home in the States, and we have more great jazz departments now than we ever dreamed we would have, and consequently, we're producing some truly great young players. However, in my case, the young men in this band are probably the approximate ages of the people who were in my first band in 1936. So my grouping has always been this way. It's just that the coach became very old in the process. That's the way it is.
You've had many bands over the years. Where and when did the term herd come from?
That was really actually my second band, the one that we began about 1944, the transition period. And George Simon, a guy who wrote several books about big bands and jazz, and who was a jazz critic back in the old days, decided that when he listened to our band, it sounded to him like a thundering herd, and that was the reason for the billing.
I mentioned to you earlier, we were talking about this, the fact that it seems that big band music is making somewhat of a comeback. And your explanation for that?
Well, I think that the main reason is the fact that there's a great deal of it being taught to kids at the high school and even junior high school level. Consequently, by the time they get into college, they're really ready for some swinging big band music. And I think that our educators are to be commended because they've done a really fantastic job in making the youth aware of a great tradition of the United States, which is American jazz music.
Once again, here is Woody Herman with his young thundering herd and their version of John Brown's Body.
Highlights of the 1983 North Sea Jazz Festival will continue with the music of Chick Corea and Gary Burton, Nina Simone, and more after this.
1983 marked the North Sea Jazz Festival's 8th anniversary. The number of visitors attracted to this musical dream of producer Paul Ackett has grown from around 9,000 in 1976 to more than 30,000 this year. It's the atmosphere, music variety, and artists that keep the people coming back each year. Artists like the duet of Chick Corea and Gary Burton. While they were getting the stage ready for Nina Simone, we spoke with one young serviceman from Camp New Amsterdam.
How long have you been over here in Europe now?
Well, I've been over here for about 8 months, and I have 3 years, so I'm planning on extending another year. I know, not for sure.
So this is your first year here in Den Haag for the North Sea Jazz Festival?
Oh, sure, yes, and I have two more to go, and I'll be back for those other two also.
What's been the highlight of this one for you so far?
Well, it's my first time here, and the people are very friendly, and I'm really enjoying myself, and I got two more to go, so I'll be back here next year also.
Thanks for stopping and talking with us.
Yeah, thanks for being on AFN also.
And now the lovely and talented Nina Simone.
How are you enjoying this North Sea Jazz Festival?
I'm enjoying it to the fullest extent, and I find it well worthwhile.
Has there been any one artist or group in particular that's impressed you?
Yes, Herbie Hancock and Waylon Marcellus definitely impressed me.
They played in the VSOP up in the PWA's off.
Yes, they have.
And play they did. Here now, featuring Herbie Hancock on piano, Wynton Marsalis on trumpet, Ron Carter on bass, Tony Williams on drums, and Branford Marsalis on saxophone, is VSOP 2. Sea Jazz Festival is truly a fun experience for the music lover. After seeing a concert, you can relax, and if you're hungry, there is plenty of food. For those who have been here before, it's a time to see an old friend or two, and for those coming to the North Sea Jazz Festival for the first time, it's a chance to just browse around and maybe make a few new friends. Jazz lovers are a unique breed of music lover. During the jazz festival season, they travel long distances just to hear their favorites play and sing. How far? Would you believe all the way from
San Francisco?
You said this is your third time in Europe?
Yes, this is my third time over in Europe, but first time in Holland.
Are you enjoying the jazz festival?
Oh, yeah. I've been thinking about this for about 3 months, you know, and after this one, I'm going to the Montreux Jazz Festival in Switzerland.
As luck would have it, we arrived at the Garden Pavilion just in time to catch one of those special moments in a concert. Albert Collins has often been called the best blues guitarist from Texas. This set with the James Cotton Band, featuring Albert Collins on lead guitar, should tell you why.
Next, Sugar Blue with the Icebreakers and the Jimmy Smith and Oscar Peterson trios as musical highlights of the 1983 North Sea Jazz Festival continue after this.
Next time you hear the Rolling Stones smash hit, I Miss You, pay special attention to the harmonica part. The man playing is Sugar Blue. Garden Pavilion, just in time to catch the Jimmy Smith Trio in the PWA Zoll.
Musical highlights of the 1983 North Sea Jazz Festival will continue after this message.
Pianist Oscar Peterson was born in Montreal, Canada, August 15, 1925. The fact that he has been responsible for many full house performances at the North Sea Jazz Festivals attests to his being a box office success. And now, in the tradition of saving the best for last, we proudly present the Oscar Peterson Trio featuring Martin Drew on drums and Niels Henning Ørsted Pedersen on bass.